Yeah. Today we are going to talk about Japheth Mwania, the former CID officer who became the head of NYS. And this is one of the recordings that I'm doing from a request of people. You know, people are telling me, comment on so-and-so, comment on so-and-so, comment on so-and-so. So kindly understand that the people you are recommending, I will comment on them. Today I'm talking about Japheth Mwania. Japheth Mwania was a very good investigator. I think for quite some time he was the provincial crime buster in Nairobi. And if I'm not wrong, it was during Washushu Wanugu and Rasta's time. He was very efficient. Actually, he rose to be a senior deputy commissioner of police. And in my view is that he should have been made the director of CID. But you see, director of CID, then, now, and whatever, has some political implications. They don't look out for the best detective. That is my opinion, and that is the opinion of JI-TENGE channel. Look at Mr. Nyaseda, who later became the commissioner. He would have been made a better director of CID than Dr. John Kamau. But some people wanted Dr. John Kamau to be the director of CID. And since Abong was retiring as the commissioner of police, they said, okay, watch a Jaluo replace another Jaluo. But sincerely speaking, if I had my way, instead of making Japheth Mwania be the director of NYS, they should have made him the director of CID. And instead of making Nyaseda commissioner of police, they would have made him director of CID. He was so good. And whenever I used to talk about him with my father, before my father died, he's one of the people whom, you know, my father, alikuwa na kasira, kidogo tu, mmekosana. So when I wanted to please him, I said, hey, Dad, do you know that Japheth Mwania cop? He would laugh. He'd say, that is a very good, efficient cop and whatever. As I've said, Mwania was very good. He would have made a very good director of CID. But for reasons that I do not know, he was taken to NYS. I'm not saying that he was poor in any... This is somebody who is very good in every place. If he would have been made a commissioner of police, he would have made a very good. If he would have headed prisons, he would have everywhere. He was good in everything. But the goodest of all goodies, the goodest of all goodies was to be the director of CID. Now, have I ever met him? Yes. And he was a very good person. Although one thing I noticed, having a father who was very harsh and disciplinarian, I would see Mwania was a very harsh and disciplinary, but to an outsider and also to a son of his boss, he was trying to be polite and whatever, but I could read between the lines that this is a very Kali person. After all, my father was also a Kali person. And you see, when you see a Kali person praising another person, most likely they are birds of a feather. My form four, we used to stay at not very far from a Methodist guest house at Valley Arcade. So when we were staying there, I remember from my standard one, apart from the Garissa house, all the houses we used to have a landline paid for by the government. And I remember the earliest we had such a house was when I was in standard two in Kajiado. So from my early age, I used to see my father when I was answering a phone. He would say, hello, had, you know, those days we, nowadays if you get a phone, it is written, hey, because the name is written on your phone. But those days it rings, you don't know who is ringing. So you say, hello. And people say, including my father when he was alive, I look like him, I talk like him, and such things. But we have two differences. One, my father talked less. And any engagement with my father lasting 30 minutes, he gets annoyed. So he used to say, yule haongei sana na yule wa nywele nyeupe. Nywele nyeupe was my father. But now I think I have nywele nyeupe. So talking to me on phone, it was very easy to confuse me with my father. And these days of video calling, I believe that if I apply a few chalks on my head, it is also easy to confuse somebody that I'm his father. I'm my own father, not his father. So, when I said hello, ah, afande, ile kesi sijui subfile sijui nini. I tried ngoja kidogo. No, afande sijui. Yes, afande, unasema nini? Do you want to talk to Mr. Kwatenge? Said, lakini afande siniongee na wewe sijui nini. Said no. By then, Japheth Mwania was an inspector and my father was a superintendent. Said, lakini kuna swali afande ulikuwa unataka kuuliza. Then I said, nilikuwa nataka kujua unataka kuongea na Mr. Kwatenge. Said, but sini wewe afande sijui nini. I said no. Mimi ni kijana yake. Said, mzee akikuja, he gave me first of all the brief of what to tell my father. Said, na sauti ni kama ya babako. Said, ata sura ni kama ya babangu. Said, then he wanted to meet me. He wanted to meet me. And when we met, he said, yes, ata sura ni kama ya baba yako. So we could meet. I remember something I learned from him when he was an inspector and I was still in school. There is one day he was the duty officer. Officer on duty. They were at railway CID, and you know, officer on duty is an inspector. So one day I was passing through there in the evening and I saw him in uniform. I said, kwani umetoka CID? Umerudi uniform? And he's the first person who told me that duty officers are all police officers of that rank, and when you're on duty at night, you have to put on full uniform. I remember when I was in my form 4 and form 5, he banned me. He refused and said, I used to like to go to this kina River Road what? Hotels, whatever. I said, oh, singia kiosk. And he really motivated. Utakuwa inspector of police. So he had even talked. There is a railway hotel. As you are going to the train, he would tell those people, wacha huyu akunywe chai, he just signed, I'll pay. He was a very good person, although he used to hide ukali chini yake. But I like him, and I admire him. He's one of the people who had a positive influence on me. Thank you.